to you live on your chin. Oh, kid. Oh. This is the Goin Deep Show.
That's it, baby.
Let's talk some shit.
Fighting for evil because good is dumb.
Stop and more Goin Deep Show, guys. Welcome to the program.
I'm the kid. Along for the ride, Fiona.
Naturally. Naturally. Let's fucking get this motherfucking party going.
If you'd like to reach out to us, studio at Goin Deep Show is the email. Hit that fucking shit up. Hit it up. This is going to be an interesting interesting topic that we're going to bring up here.
I'm going to shock the fuck out of this guy that... I'm going to shock the fuck out of him. I'm going to scare him away.
Oh, yeah? The one who you were talking to earlier tonight?
Yeah. I'm going to scare him away. He's going to fucking be like, oh, my God, this bitch.
I think you scare many people away.
I don't get it. Like...
Some people can't handle such awesomeness.
I'm too dirty.
Some people like to try to jump on the bull and ride, and they get thrown real fast and hard.
Well, clearly, like that bitch at work the other day, who never fucking heard the podcast. Clearly,
we say some things on this podcast here. We encourage you guys, okay, to learn how to use buttons and knobs and things. I know you have a phone, and there's no, it's just a piece of glass. We get it. It's hard to really control what goes on that piece of glass. But we know you're smart enough to figure out if you need to turn some shit off, just do it, okay?
If you don't like what I'm saying, don't fucking listen.
If there's a time to just evaluate your life and ask yourself, can I handle the words coming out of other people's mouths? You should really, this is the time to fucking figure that out, okay? We don't want you around if you're going to give us shit later for choosing to hear the things we say. That's just fucking retarded.
I've never understood offended people.
No.
Like, unless it's directly at you, why do you fucking care?
Which we can make it directly at whoever it wants to be.
100%.
If the shoe fits, man, you wear that shit, right? Isn't that the way they say it?
I would have to say that's accurate. 100% yeah. Accurate.
People are sensitive. Just get over it, okay? It's
getting in
fine.
My fucking face, you fucking fat cunt.
Uh-oh. Pescadios.
Don't get in my fucking face.
I didn't get in your face.
That fucking pissed me off.
I know it did. We
And the bitch didn't even know the fuck she was talking about. Fucking retard. You clearly didn't fucking hear the goddamn podcast. Listen to Snoopy. You don't listen to shit, no. Dumb bitch.
When people assume that they know what the fuck is up with shit, I always get really worried because...
They're the ones that fucking cause problems.
And this just goes back to, like, covering our asses when it comes to, just trying to have a good time. We're not asking everyone to come along for the ride and try to resist hearing us. You know damn well, these assholes are pissing and moaning. I didn't hear it. They're the ones who are listening to it more than anybody. Let's be real. You know that's the case, right?
I know a lot of people were, and a lot of people fucking enjoyed it. I know that bitch didn't, and she fucking made shit up like she fucking did. Not even a fucking minus the part where it's like dirty, disgusting, and vulgar. That's true, but like otherwise.
Yeah, thanks for the compliments.
Otherwise, yeah, like otherwise, you don't know the fuck you're talking about, you dumb fucking cunt.
Isn't everything now? You can't really call people out about being offensive on any level because.
I'm offended that you're offended, you stupid bitch.
Exactly. So, and then like. Everybody has their different genders and all these different wacky, weird things going on. And we're all supposed to be inclusive and love everyone, no matter how fucked up they are. So how come us as individuals, saying whatever the fuck we want to say freely, we should be awarded. We should be, people should be praising us for being the people who say the shit we say.
People should be. But everybody who doesn't have a problem with it, they're afraid of the people who do have a problem with it.
But there can't be that many of them. There can't be that many people who are that butthurt. Even the ones who have these false outrage about everything, you know, even they can't.
No, but they're the squeaky wheel.
Yeah. Yeah, but they're so fucking gray. They're trying to be white and they're gray. That's why they try to make everybody else look fucking worse so that they look better.
When you fucking blend into the fucking wallpaper, you gotta do something to stand out. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna fucking go after the people that stand out.
I told you that, yeah. You're the shiny object there, Fiona. You know that.
It's bullshit. It's fucking bullshit.
It's because you're a smoke show. You're hottie. Everybody loves you. Except these dumb cunts, twats who can't fucking.
Oh, they just envy me. Fuck right off, bitches.
Let's be real. Their pussies probably just smell really bad.
Oh, stinky pussy.
They got stinky, nasty pussies.
Thing is, you don't have to fucking. You don't have to hate me. It's not like I fucked your husband.
Not yet, she hasn't. It's on her to-do list, though. I've seen the checklist. She's got a bucket list known as the fuck-it list, and she's coming after you guys. You watch it. You can't resist her. You just can't.
The amount of resistance is, like, minimal. And even that'll buckle.
Yep, it will. Give it up, motherfuckers. You're never going to resist. Okay? How the fuck have I done it so far?
Because we actually give a fuck.
I know we do. We really care about each other. That's why we don't do that shit.
Don't fucking do it. Don't do it.
No, that's why we're going to do virtual reality fucking. That's how we solve these problems. We're problem solvers, motherfuckers. Okay?
Well, I mean, unless you're goddamn Bible-thumping, holy-rolling motherfucker, and then, you know, jacking off is cheating.
How many dogs licking my balls and shit?
That's cheating.
With peanut butter.
That's cheating. You're cheating with a dog.
Oh, man. Is it really cheating though? Because I don't.
It is cheating if you're that person.
But I'm not. I don't have anybody to like cheat against.
Different because you're cheating on God.
Oh God!
Listen to the music, motherfucker.
Cheating on God. This is perfect because we wanted to lead into this story about monogamy.
Segue.
Three scientific reasons monogamous relationships do not work. Now this is gonna be. This is going to ride us through to the end of this show. I know it because we're going to have so much to say.
Buckle up, bitches.
There are many romantic things about monogamy. According to the dictionary, the monogamous definition is having only one mate, spouse, or sexual partner at one time. So you can still be a whore, but you can be a monogamous whore.
Well, apparently I am a monogamous whore then.
So like you can have one partner at a time. So like each week for 52 weeks, you got 52 different partners. You're a fucking slut. Let's be real. I'm a monogamous slut, though. To many people, monogamous. Right? It's true.
52-week fucking slut.
Damn. To many people, monogamy means having a support system in your spouse or partner, someone you can rely on and spend time with. It means you can share your love with each other only, and that doing so is enough in your relationship. Okay. That sounds like many friends you have. I mean, realistically, half of that, besides any romantic things, is describing you and I. You know?
I'm going to go jack off after this.
relying on someone, spending time with them, sharing your love with each other. You know, I think, you know, we have some of that shit, but we don't have any of the romancy, you know, brony type shit that you have with that little midget. And... monogamy is largely what we see in movies and on TV. Did I say that out loud? Shit. Oops.
Allegedly.
Holy fuck.
It's what we see in TVs and movies and stuff and what the institution of marriage was built on. Conventional marriage means husband, wife, take a vow to be faithful to their each other in sickness, in health, all that bullshit. And
so you're a crippled-ass bulldog-looking motherfucking bitch laying in a bed.
And speak to the potential of their union. Oh, union. Yes, having one person who knows you inside and out for the rest of your life is a beautiful thought. You may even think of sitting next to one another in a rocking chair on the porch when you're in your 90s, reminiscing of all the old wonderful years you spent together. Fuck that shit. That, I mean, it does sound okay, I guess, but I mean, come on, really? But yeah, you still want to be railing. Relying on one person makes life a lot simpler in some ways. But is monogamy natural? Okay, so now we're getting into the meat and potatoes of this fucking thing. According to science, monogamous relationships might not be the norm. These three reasons are to blame, okay? Now here's the reasons we're blaming these. Scientific reasons monogamy relationships do not work. Here it is. Number one. Men and women lose interest in sex over time. Oops, that's too loud. Men and women lose interest in sex over time. for ladies loving usually goes out the door. You may try to spice things up with lingerie, new moves in the bedroom. Science shows women aren't designed for long-term desire. Research has found that women tend to go from having passionate love to compassionate love over time. So from passionate to compassionate.
So I want
to
fuck too. I just want to make you feel good. I don't really give a fuck about me. Just get your nut off and get off me.
Probably. I can say, yeah, I can.
I've been there.
Yeah.
I've been there.
The relationship turns into more of a platonic friendship, and that's not something you want in a romantic relationship. Save the platonic love for your Saturday girls' night out. Human beings are clearly evolved for sex lives featuring multiple simultaneous sexual relationships, says Christopher Ryan, PhD. So I don't know. I mean, so what you do is you lose interest in the one person. So the only way to spice it up is to have to not be monogamous and go off with other people.
I can see that. Well, then you introduce porn. Hello.
VR porn, man.
VR
porn. I'm telling you, that VR thing's going to solve a lot of this problem.
We're just going to fucking circle back. VR porn.
Number two, monogamy kills women's best years of sex.
So, like, I could be a freak with, like, 500 people, or I could be a freak with one person until I'm bored.
Until I'm bored. You've probably heard before, but men hit their sexual peaks in their 20s. Women typically don't reach it until their late 30s, early 40s. Furthermore, science has found that women who are in relationships throughout these prime years report low sexual desire, when in reality, these are the years they should be having the best sex of their lives. So,
yeah.
Okay. That one seems like you could solve it if you're...
Cheat.
Which is funny because that's number three. We naturally want to cheat. I can honestly say it's the second that you kind of like tie yourself to one person is the second you really start looking everywhere else. I told my ex-wife that before we got married, I said, let's not do this. I don't think we should get married. I'm into this relationship more than I ever will be once you shackle that ball and chain to me.
That's a mental thing.
Because once we're together and I can't. We're going to be together.
Well, really, you shouldn't. Even if you're not married, you shouldn't be fucking venturing out.
You shouldn't be venturing out, but even just, you know as well as I do. You see something attractive, your eyes drawn to it. It's natural to have that.
Yeah, I mean, I get it, but...
According to the Natural Science Foundation, only 3 to 5% of mammals are monogamous. How's that for a harsh slap in the face? Reality can suck sometimes. Studies have found that sexual monogamy also relies on hormones and receptors that the brain releases. Human receptors vary from person to person, resulting in some people leaning more towards polyamory than others. I think that you and I have discussed this in the past where the whole once a cheater, always a cheater thing. I don't believe that's the case. I really don't.
I don't either.
I believe if I'm with the right person, it's me and them, man, and we're going to fucking destroy the rest of the fucking planet together, and it's going to be fine.
Yeah.
You know, and that's kind of what you want. It's what you're looking for, too.
Yeah. That's why I've remained fucking solid for the last fucking almost year, yeah. Regardless.
Just don't find, yeah. Don't get with indecisive people. That's the lesson learned
here. That's a fucking fact.
I've been with some indecisive motherfuckers before.
Some bullshit. It's bullshit. You went this direction, guess what? Fucking keep fucking going.
So now with that in mind, I want to tell everybody, tomorrow I'm going to meet some girl for the first time, and I'm always leery on telling about the podcast. I'm always leery about meeting somebody new, introducing them to my life, and I have to really kind of be conscious of like if they're going to be, where it's going to go, what it's going to do. It's just, you know, you brought it up the other day when we were hanging out and I told you about this person, and you're like, really, you're going to, it's another person from the other side of the state. They live like 2 hours away. Part of me kind of, I think, does this on purpose in a weird roundabout
way. Trying to keep
them
like a little bit away, a little bit.
It's not even keeping away. It's just like, I think the hardest part of having a relationship when somebody's in town is you have the opportunity to I miss them, and then, okay, I'm not going to miss them anymore because I'm going to see them in like 2 seconds. I can drive to them. I can go be with them. I can go here, go there. I kind of liked the former girlfriend where she had to come across the state, and I had a chance to get things done. I had the opportunity to just, I don't know, it just...
The hard part is like when you want to spend more time with them and they're so far away.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And I mean, I guess that makes the next encounter great, but at the same time, like, especially like people that have to, like, I gotta go home because I got a job, I got shit to do, I got, you know, a spouse and kids.
Did you get amped up? Yeah. I wasn't jacking it either with VR porn at the time. And I'm going to try not to do that again. It's going to be difficult. I know. Everybody's laughing right now.
Not me. I'm going to go use my vibrator in about 5 minutes.
I can hear you laughing. Which one you got? Have you got
the one you sniffed?
You got that womanizer one out yet?
I've
get that fucker working.
I still haven't quite figured out how to use it. I mean, I'm trying, but it's like
everybody we're taking. Oh yeah, you know what we've been forgetting to do.
But
tell everybody that we have Limp Bizkit tickets.
Still, I thought about that before we even started, and then I forgot.
We're giving away Limp Bizkit tickets, but one of the things I was gonna say is, if you want to submit a resume to help Fiona figure out how to use the womanizer, it doesn't, male, female, we're not going to discriminate. I'm sure there's some woman out there who knows how to use the womanizer.
Use it the right way so that I'm like fucking like, God damn, this was totally worth all the fucking money.
How much was that fucker? Like $200?
$250. I wasn't going to fucking do it, but I'm like.
I bought a Lilu for Red.
I have one of those. It broke. I broke it.
You broke it? What color was yours?
Black.
It
looked like a little slug.
She had the orange one.
Fun.
I said, the only way I buy a new vibrator that costs that much is if it's orange. Creamsicle. I remember using that fucker around while I was eating her at the same time.
That's hot. It's just fucking hot.
Yeah, because when my tongue got tired, I just like stuck it underneath it and let it do the work for me.
That's smart.
Yeah, you got to keep it going.
Yes.
No fake chowing.
Mm-mm.
No.
Mm-mm.
We gotta love the vibration talks.
Mm-hmm.
I'm telling you, this is another thing. We're gonna figure this out, Fiona. Okay?
I hope so.
Somehow, we're gonna find a way. Whether you're Dutch ruddering me, I don't know. We're gonna figure some shit out. One way, shape, or form. A non-touching. Somehow, we're gonna hook up a broomstick between our arms.
To the cabbage patch.
Yep, exactly. Something. We're going to figure it out. It's all we got is each other at this point. That's all we do. We got nothing else. We can't provide anything else for people, apparently. They don't like us long enough to stick around, hang with us.
Well.
And they're home crying. Crying in their bed next to...
Gremlins.
Gargoyles and...
Fucking...
I almost called it Gargamels. From the Smurf.
Holy fuck.
She's balding. She's got that little fucking...
The tuft.
Fucking shit.
Holy Christ.
We're retarded. I love everything about our retardedness.
I know. Seriously, I'm gonna go jack off.
Are you?
Oh, yeah. You're fucking welcome.
I'm gonna go watch. Come on, so friends do.
Friends help friends.
If I wasn't a friend, I would be fucking helping her jack off. I mean, let's be real. But a friend just watches.
I'm not gonna get physically involved, but I'm definitely gonna keep my eye on you.
Yep. Either that, or I'm just gonna listen.
That's what friends do. They keep their eyes on each other.
Yep. And they may apply like some type of whipped cream or some type of lubricant.
Just fucking slip and slide shit. Oh, God.
Oh, I love poking the bear. I've been the kid. This is going deep. So Fiona, get fan words.
I'm going to go jerk off.
Is it charged?
They're all charged.
Okay. She's got a whole arsenal.
I got a fucking army of fucking toys.
She looks like Danny Trejo from Desperado when he's got all those knives on him, you know? Ding, 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 ding. Fucking throwing knives at fucking Antonio Banderas. You know what I'm talking about.
I do.
I'm kidding. This is the Goin Deep Show. If you seriously want some Limp Bizkit tickets, so get a hold of us. Studio at Goin Deep Show, the email. We'll give them away to you. Okay? All you gotta do is come and stare at Fiona while she uses her vibrator.
Yep.
For the rest of the crew, thank you for tagging along and doing what you do. The summer is coming, everybody, just like Fiona will be. I'll see you soon. Till the next one.
Oh, yeah. Oh yeah.
Oh yes.
Oh yeah. Fuck yeah. Together. Oh my God.
Scientific reasons monogamous relationships don't work. This is gonna be good.
Yeah. Yeah.
We should just start it up.
We could. That'd be perfect. We'll do this fucking episode and then I'll go to bed and then I'll wake up and take the fucking kids to school.
Yep.
We could do more episodes.
You ever heard
this?
Good
morning.
Dick liquor cocksucker. Okay. Yeah, let's do this and go to bed.
That's fantastic.
I'll keep everything set up here.
Yes.
And then, yeah, I'm trying to think.
I just gotta get a couple things done before I leave.
He took the laptop. I just remember that. Good thing you got your own, though. I don't use the laptop anymore. I don't give a shit.
I don't have high hopes for tomorrow.
No.
I have a feeling. Because you know how you always post your best photos and shit?
Yeah.
I have a feeling this chick's not all she's cracked up to be. You know?
I mean, I post my best photos, but I am me.
But you're, yeah, but you're, yeah, but when you see you in your photos, you're even better in person.
Well, that's cool. You know?
If she's better than in her photos, I'm gonna be shocked.
She might be. Or she could be like a fucking sausage stuffed in a fucking casing. Like, she's a little thick in the pictures. When you get in person, she's like a fat fatty. And you're like, well, she's got a pretty face. I can fuck her anyway.
The thing is, like, Red was not the tiniest of little ladies.
Well, she's curvy.
She's like a mega curvy. Back in the day, she was super curvy. So I'm not against that. I don't discriminate in that kind of a way. Don't get me wrong. I like my thin, tall, tiny little fucking...
Do fucking rolls gross you out?
Sometimes, yeah.
Because that was like... Chris was looking at my ass today. Because I dropped that 10 pounds in a week. And he's like, your fucking legs are way skinny. I'm like, guess what happens?
I said that just a little bit ago.
When I drop weight, my legs get real skinny. Like, they're already fucking skinny legs. I got chicken legs. No, I don't have chicken legs, but I got thinner legs. I don't have fucking fat thighs. I don't have, my fucking shit doesn't rub together and fucking, you know, start a fire. But like, he's like, because we got in the hot tub and we're sitting there bullshitting. And he's like, you don't have a goddamn ounce of cellulite on your fucking anywhere. And I'm like, I know.
You dropped 10 pounds quick.
I don't have cellulite anyway. I just don't. Some people just don't have cellulite.
You're lucky.
I know. But I also don't have a fucking like svelte goddamn like toned fucking physique either. I'm sloppy skinny.
You were just letting the dog out like 15, 20 minutes ago. And you're toned in a way that you just, I don't think you recognize. I think, yeah, you are. Your women wish they were as naturally genetically gifted as you are. There's no doubt. Yeah.
Maybe my upper half. My fucking lower half is sloppy. It's skinny, but it's sloppy.
I don't work on it. I've not seen or spent a lot of time with your lower half.
My fucking,
you walk by and I'm just like, oh, there she goes again.
My lower unit, yeah. If I fucking put effort into it, I would be toned below the waist too. Like, I'm just, my legs are thin.
Do some squatties or something.
My ass is small. I don't really want a fat ass. I don't really see the appeal in a fat ass.
No, I hate that shit. I hate the fat butts.
Big fucking giant fat fucking ass. Like, I want to be able to wear my pants without them fucking like screaming to be fucking like released.
Let me out.
Seriously,
let
like
me out.
I'm fucking ashy. Like, I don't know. Like, some guys are into that shit, and it's like,
no,
good for you.
No, it's got to be nicely balanced. It has to be balanced between all sorts of things. Nice legs, nice ass, tinier midsection, bigger boobs, good face,
to
nice
me?
Hair, eyes. There's so many pieces. There's so many things, you know.
To me, a fucking, that's like kind of like a fucking, like a, what's the word? when you've got like somebody with a giant fat fucking ass and thighs, and then they got this little tiny waist.
I don't like that. Like Kim Kardashian type shit?
I don't, yeah, that giant fucking ass just, I don't think it's an attractive thing.
Mm-mm.
Like, if you have one, you have one. If you have one, you have one. If that's the way you're built, that's the way you're built. But to fucking work to get it to the, like, no. Don't fucking work to make your ass fat. Strong, muscular, whatever.
Because at some point you're going to stop working on it and it's just going to get droopy as shit.
A dumpy fucking ass.
Yeah, you're going to have a huge pumpkin back there. Yeah, it's not going to be good.
You're wearing fucking your fucking mom jeans.
It's like, hey, look who just walked in.
Some of the comments are so outlandish.
I'm the happiest son of a bitch in the world.
But it irritates me. Like, I don't hear these bitches like, now, I don't disagree with fucking working to get a nice firm ass.
Mm-hmm.
And something back there to, like, you know. But, like, you gotta have something to grab onto,
here's,
I think.
Here's what it comes down to. Your booty probably you would consider as a smaller. It is a smaller booty. But you can, you know, bend over, arch your back a little, do some things to kind of like
bring out those curves.
Yeah. Women who don't even have to do that shit, they're in some trouble. They're in some trouble in the long run because when they don't want to have that big old ass, they don't have the option. It's just there.
I've never wanted to have, never. Never, ever have I wanted to have a big fucking fat ass.
I don't give a fuck.
That's what you think about the ass, right?
I think that women that do have fat asses, that like, you know, it's like that is, you got what you got. You know, you fucking work it how the fuck ever you want to work it. But my fucking ass isn't going to be doing like 500 fucking million fucking squats and shit and bullshit. No. If I'm going to do that,
it's too much.
If I'm going to do that to an extent, it's because I want it to be a nice firm ass, not because I want it to be a fat fucking muffin.
You ever have people, this is a weird one. I've signed people's butts, painted people's butts.
Yeah.
Not people's, women's butt. Endo, I used to draw on her ass all the time.
Yeah.
Yeah. I have pictures of my drawings on her back and lower back and butt and everything. And there's something hot about that. The liquid latex thing I've always wanted to do. I've always wanted to do painting on women and stuff like that. And
yes.
We've been talking about your photo shoot. We should really do that now that you've... not that you needed to. I don't want you to kick me later.
I know what you're going to say.
You're in shape. You got this.
But that was one of my problems was, man, I got to drop a couple pounds.
Yep.
Done.
We're ready to go.
Done. Thanks, Brony. Done.
Yep. We're going to do the pictures. I'm thinking...
Because I'm a stressed starboard.
I'm thinking this weekend...
Tomorrow night, we're supposed to go to the party store out in Midland and get like, I gotta get like a bunch of fucking those olives with the capers and the goddamn garlic and the fucking mozzarella and the fucking sun-dried tomatoes and all that bullshit.
Uh-huh.
We always do that shit. It's an annual thing.
How many people are going? How many people are in this thing?
One's missing it because her husband's in the hospital. So there's gonna be, and the other one's missing it because it's like some other bullshit. So there'll be four of us this time around.
Good to get out of town.
That's a good group of friends. I created this fucking thing.
Did you?
I created this thing. I created tailgating illegally and work illegally. Fucking, I come up with all these great fucking ideas to like do things that like get you in fucking trouble or have a good time. Or both.
I predict the Halloween party could be happening this year.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I'll be having some parties here, actually, by the way.
All right, let's start
one
this.
One big party and then like some small get-togethers.
Let's start this fucker.
Shit. All right. All right.